So now we've gone through the basics of JavaScript syntax, structuring and interacting with JSON data, and requesting data from a server. Now we need to talk about how to interface to the browser. More specifically, we need to talk about the DOM, or document object model. The DOM is an interface to the structure of an HTML document, for example, the head or body element. The DOM allows us to access and modify our HTML document dynamically using JavaScript. Our game is primarily going to exist within a single element, the canvas, which we'll get into later. But what this means is that we won't have a lot of reason to heavily access the DOM. In fact, we're only going to need a few things. So let's take a look at a quick example. Let's say you want to validate whether a user has entered a valid password into an input field. Here's how you would do that using the DOM API in JavaScript. You can see the basic HTML here with the form and the password input and the submit button. And we have a script down here where we start executing our JavaScript. First, we have this document.getElementById method. What this does is grab a DOM element of the given ID. In this case, it's example form, which is right here. So it would grab this entire form. When it's submitted, we run this function in here. Now, you don't really need to worry about the password regex too much. We're interested in this part down here. Now, if the password doesn't match, then we create a new ptag element, assuming it doesn't already exist. We check if it exists by, again, using the document.getElementById method and checking for the ID notify. If it doesn't exist, we use the document.createElement method, specify a ptag. This parameter is just the name of a type of element, for example, p, or form, or canvas. Now we set the text content of that ptag to this bit here, and we set the ID attribute to notify. That way, if we submit multiple times, we don't simply create a new ptag every single time. Finally, we grab a reference to the body tag, since the body element has an ID of body, we can do that. And we append notify to the body. Now, if we look at this in our browser, we can see we have an input form with a submit button. And you can see our basic HTML down here. However, if we submit an incorrect password, press submit, we can see that this pops up right here, which is the text that we set our ptag to. You can also see that this ptag was created down here with an ID of notify and the correct text. You can also see that if we keep pressing submit again, more ptags don't get created since we made that check.